Hello everyone, now we are going to solve the next question on the design of the flywheel ring. In this question it is written as if the rotating mass of the rim type flywheel, what it is? That is, you must understand what type of flywheel it is saying that the rim type flywheel is distributed on another rim type flywheel. So both the flywheel are of rim type, okay, whose mean radius, that means the mean radius for the second rim type flywheel is half of the mean radius of the former. Okay, so if the mean radius of the second is R2, so it is equal to half of the mean radius of the former. Okay, so this is R1 by 2. So then energy stored in the latter at the same speed will be, we all know what is the energy stored, it is talking about the delta E. Okay, we know that delta E is equal to I omega square Cs. We know that delta E is equal to I omega square Cs. Cs is constant, basically it is a function of the, that is the speed and the mean speed also. So we can say that the speed is, you can say here in the question it is written as at the same speed. Okay, that is, it means it is talking about the same mean speed. That means omega must be constant. And Cs is always the coefficient of speed. Okay, coefficient of fluctuations of speed. So it is always a constant. So basically, I omega square Cs. So I can write that delta E is directly proportional to the E, moment of inertia, because omega is constant in this case, because in the question it is given that energy stored in the latter at the same speed. So that means speed is same for both the cases. So basically delta E is directly proportional to the moment of inertia. This is basically the mass moment of inertia, and we know that I is equal to mk square, where m is the mass of the flywheel and k is the radius of gyration. I already told you that the radius of gyration is equal to r upon root 2 in case of what? r upon root 2 in case of disc. Okay, so it is for disc. Okay, but k is equal to r in case of rim. If the flywheel is of rim type, moment that means the radius of gyration would be the radius of the flywheel. Okay, so that is k is equal to r for rim type of flywheel. In the question our flywheel is of rim type in both the cases, so that means the radius of gyrations would be same. So it is asking that the energy stored in the latter, that means it is asking about the E2. Okay, so E2 upon E1 is equal to I2 upon I1, yes or no? I2 upon I1, and I2 is nothing but the mk square. That means I can write it as mr2 square. Okay, mr2 square upon mr1 square. Okay, so that is nothing but E2 upon E1. So R2 upon R1 is nothing but, if you write down the R2 upon R1, you will get the value of 1 by 2. So that is nothing but the 1 by 2 the whole square, and that means you will get the value E2. That means energy stored in the latter would be the 1 by 4th of the energy stored in the former. Okay, so that would be the E1 by 4th, that means 1 4th of the first one. So option C would be the correct answer. I hope you will understand the solution of that question. Again, I am explaining this question as we know that the maximum fluctuations of the energy, that is nothing but delta E is equal to I omega square Cs. Cs is the coefficient of fluctuations of speed. Okay, this is constant. However, it is nothing mentioned about the coefficient of fluctuations of speed, so we can say this is constant, and it basically depends on the delta E is depend on moment of inertia and the mean speed. Here energy stored in the latter at the same speed will be asking, that means the omega is given that it is same for both the cases. So that means only one variable, that is I, remaining. So delta is directly proportional to the mass moment of inertia. So you can calculate the E2 upon A1 is basically equal to the I2 upon I1. Okay, so we all know that mass moment of inertia is equal to mk square, where k denote the radius of gyration. Radius of gyrations will be different for the different type of flywheel. If it is a disc type flywheel, radius of gyrations would be r by root 2. If radius of gyration is equal to r, that means the flywheel is of rim type. Okay, so basically you can calculate the E2 upon E1, you will get the value of E2. That means energy stored in the latter would be 1/4 of the first one. So option C would be the correct answer. Okay, so I hope you will understand the solution of that question.
Thank you.